Hello students, in chemistry chapter 2, now we are going to study the next separation technique and it is the dye in black ink a single color? As we know that ink is, what is ink? Ink is mixture of dye and water. Okay, now we want to know that this dye which is present in the ink, this dye is a single color or it is mixture of different colors. So this method is different from evaporation. In evaporation, we have separated dye from water, and in this technique we are separating different colors of a dye. We want to know first that dye is a single color or it is mixture of colors, okay, and then we will separate these colors of a dye. So the method used here is chromatography. This is a different technique known as chromatography. What is the principle behind this method? It is the technique used for separation of those solutes that dissolve in the same solvent. Means when in a single solvent, when there are two or more solutes are dissolved in a single solvent, then this technique of chromatography is used to separate those solutes. Okay, now for this, what we have to do, this is the diagram of chromatography method. What we will do, we will take a thin strip of filter paper. We have taken this thin strip of filter paper. Then we will draw a line on it using a pencil. And this line should be approximately 3 cm above of the lower edge of the filter paper. Now what will we do? We will put a small drop of ink from a sketch pen or fountain pen, from any of it, we'll put a small drop of ink at the center of this line, and then we will leave it, let it dry. Now when this drop will get dry, then what will we do? We will lower this filter paper in a glass jar. We have taken this a glass jar. We will keep this filter paper inside it, and with the help of a glass rod and paper clips. Okay, and we have to fill this glass jar with water also. And we have to take care that this drop of ink should be above the level of water. Now leave this system for some time undisturbed and watch carefully. Now what will happen? This filter paper is dipped in water, then it means this filter paper will absorb the water. Okay, so this water will raise, this filter will absorb it slowly and slowly, and this water will raise up. Okay, so the ink we use has water as a solvent. As we know that ink is mixture of dye and water, so the ink drop is, it is a mixture of, it has water as a solvent and dye is soluble in it. Now as the water rises on the filter paper, it takes along with it the dye particle. When this water will rises on the filter paper, what will happen? It will take the dye of the ink. It will take the dye particle also with it. Okay. And in actual dye is a mixture of two or more colors. So what will happen? The colored component that is more soluble in water rises faster, and in this way the color gets separated. When the water will absorb this dye, the dye is a mixture of two or more colors. The color which is more soluble in water, that will rise faster. So what will happen? We will take out the filter paper and we will dry this filter paper. When we will dry this filter paper, what we will see? We will see 2-3 different color dots in that filter paper. Okay, and this filter paper is known as chromatogram. this filter paper is known as chromatogram. So what does it show? It shows that the dye present in the ink is not a single color, it is mixture of two or more colors. Now these colors have been separated on the filter paper, which shows that dye is mixture of colors. So this method is known as chromatography. Now, what are the applications of chromatography method? It is used to separate, as we have studied, colors in a dye. Second application is, it is used to separate pigments from natural colors. And third application is, it is used to separate drugs from blood. So, chromatography method is very important. These are the applications of chromatography: to separate colors in a dye, pigments from natural colors, and drugs from blood. Thank you.